Hey guys, so now Winter Olympics at Sochi, Russia has pretty much drawn to a close. How's it ended? Not really sure. It kind of tells you how much I follow the Olympics. Not really. I watched some of it with my friend last week, I think. I watched a great deal of it with my friend, mainly ice dancing and bobsledding and all those kind of events. But this video isn't really about me following the Olympics, which I did very little of. Unfortunately, I wanted to, but time was kind of the thing, and also access. I don't really have TV, so I didn't really watch it that much. But in this video, I want to talk about the impact of Olympics. Not just this particular Olympics, but the impact of an event like Olympics. It's a global event. One city, one nation kind of holds this space so that all these countries, all these teams from different countries can come together and kind of compete in all kinds of different sports. That's Olympics. I think it's an amazing, remarkable event. But at the same time, that kind of remarkable event requires something, some crazy work. And in the case of Sochi, which I think is extremely interesting, an entire city pretty much had to be created for this event. Or let's say recreated in a way. Because Sochi, before Olympics, is kind of known as a vacation spot, kind of for... It's more of like a beach area. It's not really known for like skiing or snowboarding. It's not a very snowy area. But for Winter Olympics, they had to really recreate the city and into a ski resort city, which is pretty ridiculous. But a lot of use of artificial snow and making up ice. They built hotels and they built airports, international airport, which is a gigantic ordeal. And they created an entire city for what? For Olympics, which lasts about 2 weeks. 2 weeks is not a short amount of time, but at the same time, when you compare the amount of effort that has gone into this recreation of the city, that's insane. Just for 2 weeks, and a lot of people that were originally living there were kind of kicked out. You know, they were either bought off or kind of, you know, let out of the city. To live elsewhere because Olympics is going to be held here. Which, if I was a resident in Sochi before Olympics, that would have been very kind of heartbreaking event in a way. Unless I was, you know, paid a lot of money to kind of go somewhere. But even so, that's uprooting of your residence. You know, you've been there and you're being kind of told to get away from there because Olympics is happening there. And I guess people kind of swallow it, some people can, because it's a matter of national pride. I don't know, that your city, that your country is holding the Olympics where hundreds of different countries will come and compete in all kinds of different sports. So there is kind of a pride thing going on there, but the cost is pretty extreme. I was talking with my friend, this same friend that I watched Winter Olympics this year with, and somehow we ended up talking about kind of Greece and its economic situation. And my friend was like, well, Greece is like that because of the Olympics. They ended up spending so much money trying to host the Olympics, and that got them into incredible amount of debt. Don't really know how true that is. I really don't know too much about Greece history or Greek culture all that much. And so I'm not sure myself how true that is. I'm going to try to maybe just assume it's true. If that's true, I mean, that just shows you the impact of something like Olympics, which is to say, insane. If hosting Olympics for 2 weeks can make a nation pretty much go bankrupt, I'm not saying that's what happened with Greece, but it can't. That's kind of the thing to really consider. You know, a matter of national pride, but it can cost so much. So what happens in Sochi after the Olympics? And I've watched like a couple of news clips here and there, and it almost seems like Russia didn't really have much of a plan. And I guess you're kind of supposed to, when you host an Olympics, you're really supposed to plan for what happens after Olympics, because that's really important, especially with Greece as an example. It's really hard though, I think, you know, after you recreate a city for Olympics, that's a humongous kind of effort and a humongous kind of impact. And I'll be curious to see what happens with Sochi. And the history of many cities that hosted Olympics, it hasn't been the prettiest picture of many cities. Some cities have survived really well, but it's not like having hosted the Olympics really gave them like a super economic boost, you know? And this is the kind of topic that we kind of have now. It's becoming more aware in our consciousness, in our public consciousness, like when NFL Super Bowl was hosted in New Jersey this year. I think it was New Jersey, yeah. There was a big talk about that, how that has pretty much severely impacted the city that hosted it. I don't even remember what city it was. Sorry, my bad. But yeah, in a hosting gigantic events like this, you're building so much resources and preparing so much for just this short amount of time. In a lot of ways, a lot of the events in the Olympics are kind of like that too. You know, speed skating down, like that's 2 minutes that you're preparing for. Figure skating, that's still like about 2 minutes that you're preparing for. Seconds matter. Bobsliding, like tenth of a second or hundredth of a second. They matter so much. And yet, how long do you prepare for these kind of events? You spend 2 years, 4 years, your life, pretty much like your early half of your life, you're preparing for those 2 minutes of your life so that they end up being like the best 2 minutes that you win against everyone and get the gold or get the silver and get the bronze. Thinking about that, I mean, that's amazing. It reminds me of a time when I was in track in high school. I did the track team and I primarily did long jump. But I also did, what is that? Not long jump, but it's like hop, hop, jump. Just triple jump, I think. That's what it's called. I did triple jump, long jump, and some kind of run. I think I did 800 meter run or something like that. But that's pretty much it. You're practicing, practicing, practicing. And at the end of the day, the actual competition that you do, long jump, 30 seconds, tops. Like that's what you get, that 30 second has to matter. And you've been practicing for months and months for those 30 seconds. It really puts that 30 seconds into perspective, you know? And I think a lot of the events in the Olympics are kind of like that. That short amount of time that you've been practicing so much for, it matters so much. And in a bigger scale, a city, a nation prepares that much and spends that much money for this short amount of event. And then now, after it's all said and done, it kind of leaves the question hanging. What happens to the city? What happens to the nation afterwards? You know, especially the city. The people of the city who were bought out and had to move to a different city because of the Olympics, you know, that's something else to think about. I know a lot of the journalists went into Sochi and they complained about, like, the condition of the hotels. And I guess that's something to complain about as well. But what about the people who were uprooted from the place they pretty much grew up in just because of this two-week event? And that to me is really the monumental impact of an event like Olympics, because that has changed lives in such a way for this kind of a national global competition event.